Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
Brother Ryan, what's your name?
Dylan,
how you doing?
I'm doing good.
All right, bro, we over here talking, teaching our people the solution. What's it gonna take for our community to change? But it takes the men to stand up first.
Right.
To change the community.
Right.
We can't stand up under Christianity.
Right.
We can't stand up under Islam. We can't stand up under none of that stuff.
Right.
We gotta come back to being the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's right.
That's the only way our people can change. That's the only way the killing in our community is gonna stop.
That's
is right. If we change our minds.
Right.
So another gospel is like another good news. So when you look at in the church, they talk about bringing good tidings, the gospel, the good news, right? So their good news is that, salvation for everybody. They say that all people are the children of God. That's not what the Bible says. Everything we say out here, we're going to back it up with the scriptures. The Bible don't say everybody is a child of God. The Bible don't say he loves everybody. The Bible does not say that God has unconditional love to his people.
Preach!
That breaks his commandments. So, but a God that loves his people will put them in this condition. I'll say that. Because God put our people in this condition for a reason. But let's go back to Deuteronomy chapter 28. Let's go back to 16. Because we were talking about being cursed in the city. So we talked about liquor stores. We talked about churches. Because what the churches and the liquor stores do, they enable our people to continue to do sin. Because like I said, they make it seem as if we can come in and get baptized and come back out and we be straight. You go in a crackhead, you come out a crackhead.
Right.
You go in a murder, you come out a murder.
Right.
You go in a fornicator, you come out a fornicator.
Right.
That's how these churches are set up. That's why you see murders like what happened here every single day.
Right.
Because our people are being enabled to sin. We don't know who we are. If you don't know who you are, you're going to make bad decisions.
Right.
That's
what our people are doing. Go back to Hosea 4 and 6 real quick. So when you look at our people, you can tell we're a destroyed nation of people. Because of how we're acting. Because of how we're acting. Because this is not the only murder. It's not the only murder this week. Last weekend there was 7 murders, 14 stabbings. For what? Is anything that serious to kill your brother for? To try to hurt your brother? Brother Ryan, what's your name?
Dylan,
how you doing?
I'm doing good.
All right, bro, we over here talking, teaching our people the solution. What's it gonna take for our communities to change? But it takes the men to stand up first to change the community.
Right.
We can't stand up under Christianity.
Right.
We can't stand up under Islam. We can't stand up under none of that stuff.
Right.
We gotta come back to being the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's right.
That's the only way our people can change. That's the only way the killing in our community is gonna stop.
That's
is
right.
If we change our minds.
Right.
Go ahead, read verse, what did I tell you to get?
4 and 6.
Hosea 4 and 6, go ahead.
The book of Hosea, chapter 4, verse 6.
Read out
my people.
Who is God's people? You know?
We are.
We are?
Us.
Us. Who's God's people? Brother Ray, what's your name?
Marquise.
Marquise. Who's God's people?
We are.
The Israelites.
That's
are God's chosen people.
That's
who God's chosen people. He said, my people, go ahead.
Are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Now it's good to hear that you God's chosen people, but he said they are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. So what is the knowledge that we lack? Because we all went to school. We all went to college. We all got an education. So what's the knowledge that we're lacking?
We lack the knowledge about ourselves.
The knowledge about ourselves.
Teach.
That's perfect. Read on.
The book of Malachi, chapter 2, verse 7.
I'm at the 4 and 6.
Book of Hosea, chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee.
So he said because we wanted to reject the knowledge that he gave us, he's going to reject us. So imagine God rejecting his people. It's not going to be I'm going to sit you in a corner and you sit in time out. He's going to kill people. He's going to put oppressive conditions.
Right.
That's what's going to happen. Read on.
Bring it out.
Then thou shalt be no priest to me.
Meaning we're not going to have no more leaders in our communities that's going to lead us the right way. Because we don't have no leaders that is trying to help our people fix this. Fix this murder. Fix the killing. There's no leaders that are helping our people change. You can come whatever solution you want to come with, but if it's not out the Bible, it's not going to change our people.
Preach!
The minds of our people have to be changed first. For you to feel like it's okay to kill your brother, if you don't fix that mindset, it don't matter. Read on.
Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God.
So the law of God is the knowledge that we were supposed to have. Go to Malachi 2 and 7. Read that.
Malachi chapter 2 verse 7.
Read it out.
For the priest's lips should keep knowledge.
The knowledge, remember, that's what we're looking for. Remember, destroy for a lack of knowledge. Go ahead.
And they should seek the law.
The what?
They should seek the law.
The education system.
They should seek the law.
College education.
They should seek the law.
Right.
At his mouth.
So we said we should seek the law at God's mouth, at the pastor's, at the preacher's mouth. That's the knowledge that our people are lacking. We're lacking a basic law. Like go to Exodus 20 and 13. This is a basic law that we're lacking. Remember, we're destroyed because we lack knowledge.
Read it out.
Exodus 20, verse 13.
The book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 13.
All right, brothers right here, brothers right here. Brothers, right here. Listen up. This is the knowledge that we're lacking. This is an example of some of the things that we're missing as a nation.
Thou shalt not kill!
Basic law, right? Something basic that our people just don't seem to want to keep. Thou shalt not kill. Is that hard?
Nope.
That's not hard. So is murder just physically going and killing somebody, or is murder something? Can it go further?
Murder. You can kill the spirit. You can kill them.
No. Murder. I know. Murder.
You know
what? Say what?
What about you?
People say they saw.
Is murder just killing? Is murder just physically killing somebody, shooting somebody, stabbing somebody? Is that the only type of murder that the Bible talks about?
Probably not.
It's not. Because murder starts somewhere, right? You gotta think about that, right? Read that.
The book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 21. Ye have heard that it was said by them of old time, thou shalt not kill.
So that's what we just read. Of old time, in the past, it was written that thou shalt not kill. Go ahead.
And whosoever shall kill shall be in danger of the judgment.
So back in that time, if you kill somebody, you had to die too. Go ahead.
But I say unto you, that whosoever is angry with his brother without cause.
So if you're angry with your brother for no good reason, you have hatred in your heart for your brother for no reason, what are you?
Shall be in danger of the judgment.
So the same judgment you received as a murderer is the same judgment you received for being angry with your brother without a cause. So go to 1 John chapter 3, verse 15. Because this is going to explain to you what we're talking about with hatred, with murder. Because it's the same thing. You got it?
Yes, sir. The book of 1 John chapter 3, verse 15. Whosoever hateth his brother.
Hey, brothers, listen up.
Whosoever hateth his brother.
He said, whosoever hates his brother. So hatred is a feeling, right? That you feel towards somebody else. It's an action as well. But a lot of times that hatred starts in our mind because something that somebody might have did to us. They might have stepped in our shoes. They might have stole something from us. They might have killed somebody. They might have hurt somebody, right? That hatred comes from different actions, right?
Is a murderer.
So if you hate your brother, you are what?
A murderer.
It's the same thing. But our men nowadays are taught to be emotional, to not know how to control their anger, to not know how to deal with conflicts amongst each other. So why is it that our men are so effeminate?
I'm good.
Why is that?
It's my son. He didn't love y'all.
It's a movement.
It's a movement. Look at Black Lives Matter. Are they about Black Lives? No, they're about something different. They're about the LGBT community's agenda. That's what they're about. So they're not really out here about Black lives, because Black people are still killing each other. I have not seen Black Lives Matter marching because of killings in the Black community yet.
Read out!
They march when a white man or a cop kills our black kids or our black sons and our daughters, right? But they're not marching about the drugs in the community. That's when the black lives are really affected with the drugs, right? Black lives are really affected with the murder, with the hatred. They're not looking to change the minds of the people. They're trying to push their agenda. Read, where'd I tell you to go?
The book of Isaiah, chapter 3 and 12. As for my people.
So who's his people? Israelites. So-called blacks and Hispanics.
Children are their oppressors.
So he said children are the oppressors of his people. What does that mean?
The younger generation.
Now you're on point. Keep going.
Basically, the younger generation would be lost.
The younger generation are the ones that oppress the people. How's the young generation oppressing the people, oppressing the nation? Go to Isaiah 51 and 20. Lie at the head of the streets.
Yes, sir.
Get there. Hold that real quick. Go to this.
Got it.
Go ahead.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 51, verse 20. Thy sons have fainted. They lie at the head of all the streets.
So we said our sons have fainted, meaning they lack knowledge. They're asleep. They're dead. Spiritually dead. Go ahead.
As a wild bull in a net, they are full of the fury of the Lord. Thy sons have fainted. They lie at the head of all the streets.
He said that our young men lie at the head of all the streets. What are our men doing on the corners of these streets?
Playing your work.
Doing what?
Playing your work.
Uh-huh. Selling drugs, right?
Drugs.
Selling drugs. Killing each other, right? That's what he's talking about. Go back to Isaiah chapter 3 and 12.
The book of Isaiah chapter 3 verse 12. As for my people, children are their oppressors.
So it's showing that the young generation is the oppressors of our people. Because when we're thinking about gangbanging, we're looking at killings, we're looking at all these different things happening to our people, or the atrocities happening to each other by our people, it's usually by the younger generation, right? It's usually by the younger generation. What happened here was by some young brother.
Preach! Right?
That's what happened. What happened days ago, because before this, there was another shooting. They were stabbing. It was by young people. Because they lack, it said his sons had fainted. We lack the knowledge that we're supposed to have. Our young men, they grow up effeminate. They're not taught the laws of God. They're raised by their mothers. It's not saying that they're doing it, that they're, it's a bad thing, but they're not. It's supposed to be a man in the house. It's supposed to be a man in the house to do what?
To lead,
to show the young boys how to be real men. Not soft men, not soft-spoken, not weak, not effeminate. There's supposed to be men in the house. Read it again.
As for my people, children are their oppressors, and women rule over them.
That's the key point. He says women rule over them. So majority of our men are raised by their grandmothers or their mothers or their aunts, by a woman. So if you're raised as a man and you're raised by a woman, what tends to happen?
Feminine.
Be that?
You grow up feminine.
Feminine, right? Right. Feminine. You grow up feminine. Because guess what? How are women? Women are naturally emotional, right?
Right.
They're naturally quick. They have a quick spark, right? What they do. Somebody give me the Willie Lynch real quick. Give me page, I think it's 6 or 7. I want to show you something, because I was explaining to the brother before that what's happening to our people is we're a product of what happened to us.
Right.
We're a product of slavery. Let's go to let's start at this right here, in my bed. So this is the Willie Lynch letter. Have you heard of it? Willie Lynch was a slave master, right? So what he did was he sent out a letter on how to make the perfect slave. Go ahead.
This is the Willie Lynch letter. In my bag here, I have a foolproof method for controlling your black slaves.
He said he has a method that you can't mess this one up. You can make a slave with this, there's no problem. Go ahead.
I guarantee every one of you that if installed correctly, it will control the slaves
for at least
300 years. My method is simple. any member of your family or your overseer can use it.
So this is the letter he sent out. He sent out a letter that would teach them how to foolproof plan on how to make an amazing slave. Go over.
The breaking process of the African woman. Take the female and run a series of tests on her to see if she will submit to your desires willingly. Test her in every way because she is the most important factor for good economics.
So the woman was the most important factor of good economics. Why? So that means that she's the most important factor today too. She's the most important factor today, but why?
She allowed for the keep the household together.
What's the true role of a woman? What's she supposed to do in the household?
Submit.
Okay. Submit. But she's supposed to take care of the kids, right? She takes care of the kids, she raises, she teaches the kids. That's a very heavy job that a woman has to do. So hats off to the women that are the single mothers that have to do it. But they know that that's a very important role for the woman to have, is that they raise the children. When the family splits, guess what? The woman always has the kids. They know that. They set it up like that. Read on.
If she shows any signs of resistance and submitting completely to your will.
So what the slave masters wanted to happen is for the women to completely submit to the will of the slave master.
Do not hesitate to use the bullwhip on her to extract that last bit of bitch out of her.
That was what they were trying to do. That's what they were trying to do with our women. Go ahead.
Take care not to kill her, for in doing so, you spoil good economics.
Why? Because she had the kids. Go ahead.
When in complete submission, she will train her offspring in the early years to submit to labor when they become of age.
So, the main point was, If she's in full submission, guess what? She's going to submit to everything that the slave master said. Right. And she's going to train her children to do the same exact thing.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.